Good morning, children. Welcome back to Sharp Creative Minds Mathematics Channel. Today, and we are going to learn one of the most important theorems in your class, that is the Thales theorem. This Thales theorem has another name. It is also called basic proportionality theorem, shortcut as BPT. So if you see anywhere in the question papers, state and prove BPT, then you have to write Thales theorem. Or the question can be asked as state and prove Thales theorem. Here, if you are asked only to write the statement, they will ask you state Thales theorem. State means you have to write only this statement. Only the statement. It will be usually asked for 1 mark. If they will ask statement, you only write the statement. But if they will ask state and prove Thales theorem, then you have to write the statement. You have to draw the related diagram. And then you have to follow the 4 steps for all the theorems. To prove any theorem, you need to follow the 4 steps. So these are the 4 steps. First one is given. Next you will have to write to prove. 3rd step is going to be construction. And 4th step is going to be proof. So these are the 4 steps that you need to follow in order to prove any theorem. Yes. So what does this Thales theorem state? A line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle at 2 distinct points divides the other 2 sides in equal proportion. Let us begin from the statement that a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. So what are the important things that are given here? A line is drawn. How it is drawn? It is drawn parallel. Where it is drawn? It is drawn on one side of a triangle. Super. A triangle has 3 sides. So we are taking only 1 side. Among those 3 sides, we are picking here any one side. There are no particular sides. Whichever is going to prove to be more convenient to us, we will be taking that side. A line drawn parallel. So let me show you. We have a triangle here, ABC. So according to the statement, a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. So this is a triangle. We want a line which is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle. So we are selecting the side BC now. If we are taking the side BC, we need to have 2 distinct points. On the other 2 sides. If I am taking the side BC, the other 2 remaining sides are AB and AC, right? So 2 distinct points are D and E. On D is the point on AB and E is the point on AC. So if I am taking the side BC and then if I join this DE, so DE is going to be parallel to BC. A line drawn parallel. So this is the line DE which is drawn parallel to BC. What is it going to do? A line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle at 2 distinct points. So a line that is DE drawn parallel to one side. One side is BC at 2 distinct points. Which are the distinct points? D and E are the 2 distinct points. What does it do? It divides the other 2 sides. Which are the other 2 sides? Other 2 sides are AB and AC. So it divides the other 2 sides in equal proportion. Yeah. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So that is going to be the equal proportion. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So that is going to be the equal proportion. But we had taken the side BC and then we had 2 distinct points D and E over here. So DE would be parallel to BC. But what if I change the side? So they have not told us to take only BC. or any particular side, it depends on us. So you should not get confused that BC means always we have to take BC only. Suppose if a question is asked to you related to this side, then you should be able to apply your logically your knowledge, and then you should be able to solve the problem. So I am dealing with all the three cases. The next one is, if I want to take AB. If I want to take AB, my two distinct, this is the side selected, means the other two remaining sides are AC and BC. So my distinct points will be D and E over here. So if I join this, it's going to be the parallel side to AB. It's going to be the parallel line to the side AB. So a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle divides the other two sides in equal proportion. So it divides like CD by DA is equal to CE by EB. CD by DA will be equal to CE by EB. Okay, this is the second case. So dear children, let us take the third case now. We have already seen with BC, we have seen with AB. The third side is AC. If in case we select the side AC, then the parallel line will be DE. So I think you have understood now how it's going to divide in equal proportion. Yes, very good. It will be dividing as BD by DA will be equal to BE by EC. So these are the three cases that I have shown to you about the line dividing the other two sides in equal proportion. So let me read the statement once again. If a line drawn parallel to one side of the triangle at two distinct points, then it divides the other two sides in equal proportion. AD by DB will be equal to AE by EC. In this case, we will be dealing with the first case. In this theorem, we will be dealing with the first case. So we are taking the base BC and parallel line as DE. Okay. So in the first step, we are going to write as given. So what do you see in the figure here? So in triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. So that is C. So that is going to be the given. In triangle ABC, that is ABC, DE is parallel to BC. That is going to be the given. So what should we prove? Next step is to prove. We should prove that AD by DB is going to be equal to AE by EC. So we need to do certain constructions over here. So what constructions should we do? So what are we supposed to do? We had an initial diagram like this, right? So in the stage of construction, we need to join this D and C, okay, and then B and E. We need to join with dotted lines, okay. So join DC and BE. So that will be the construction, join DC and EB. So that is going to be the construction. Then we need to draw a perpendicular line from here. Need to draw a line which is perpendicular. It should be exactly 90 degree over here, and then we need to name the line. So we can draw here EN. I am taking this N, and here also we need to draw another perpendicular line on AC that we are going to name as M. So what have we done the construction? We have joined DC. That is the construction, and we have joined BE. Then we have drawn EN. This should be perpendicular to AB. And then we have drawn EM. That is perpendicular to AC. This itself we are going to write in construction. So my dear students, I think you are able to see clearly in this diagram the construction part. I have drawn particularly using different colored sketch pens so that you can clearly get the idea. This dotted line that is joining BE is the construction part and this joining DC is the construction part. Again, we have drawn perpendicular EN on AB, similarly DM on AC. So this we will mention in the construction. So join DC, so DC and EB, so we will join it. Draw EN perpendicular to AB, right? And DM perpendicular to AC, so DM perpendicular to AC, right? Okay, now when we look at the diagram, we need to prove that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Can you recall the formula to find the area of a triangle? Yes. Students, we are going to make use of the formula to find the area of the triangle as 1 by 2 into base into height. So 1 by 2 b into h, we are going to make use of this formula to prove this Thales theorem. So I just want to clear with you the concept of base and height. So suppose if this is a triangle and I am taking the base, this one. If I am taking the base, then this is going to be the height. Of course, we need to draw it with scale, but I am not using the scale right now. So this is going to be the height. So if this is the base, this is going to be the height. If I just turn this triangle like this, so can you guess which is the base now? Yes, if I turn it like this. So this is the base and this is going to be the height. If I turn this same triangle this way, this is going to be the base and this is going to be the height, right? This is for any acute angle triangle, but the case changes for obtuse angled triangle. In case of any acute angled triangle, we can find the height of the triangle inside the triangle. We can find its height inside the triangle. So this is the second case. I have a triangle ABC over here. If this was the first case, that we had the base here and height here. Okay, I told you that in any acute angled triangle, the height lies inside the triangle. I have another example over here. So this is going to be the right angled triangle. If I place the triangle this way, BC is going to be the base and AM is going to be the height of the triangle. This is of course a right angled triangle and we can see the height inside the triangle itself. If I change it like this, see, this is ABC triangle. If we look at this, it's going to be the hypotenuse. And of course, this is again going to be the height AM of the triangle, which lies inside the triangle. Okay. But in case, can you guess which type of triangle it is? Yes, it is an obtuse angle triangle. In case if we have the obtuse angle triangle, then we are not going to draw the height this way. Okay, for any obtuse angled triangle, its height is going to be outside the triangle. Its height will be lying towards the outside. See, like this. See, for an obtuse angled triangle, where does the height of the triangle lie? The height of the triangle lies outside the triangle, not inside. But it can be the any triangle, like acute angled triangle or an right angled triangle. I'll show you all the three cases. This is acute angled triangle and this is a right angled triangle. So we have the heights inside the triangle. But in case of an obtuse angle triangle, the height lies outside the triangle. So this is the concept that you should clear in mind, because once the concept is cleared, everything is clear. Everything is understood. So we will follow concept of height in both acute angled as well as obtuse angled triangle in this Thales theorem. We will be making use of this formula now. Area of the triangle is equal to half base into height. So to prove the Thales theorem, we will first take area of triangle, ADE. To prove the theorem, we will first take the area of the triangle ADE. Here I would like to add one more thing to you. In this case, we have three triangles. One is triangle ADE, another is triangle BDE, and another is triangle CDE. See, my dear children, this DE we have common in all the three triangles. Only we need to change the alphabets A, B, and C. So in our first case, we are going to take these two triangles, triangle ADE and BDE. In the next case, we will be taking the other two triangles ADE and CDE. So this concept is going to prove very easy to all of you. So we are going to follow three triangles ADE and BDE in the first case, and ADE and CDE in the second case. So we will take the next as proof. That is the next step. So what is the proof? We want area of triangle ADE. As I told you, we are going to take two triangles first. Area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE. So we already have used this formula. I told you that half base into height. So any area of the triangle is going to use this formula itself, half base into height. So area of triangle ADE. Yes, my dear students, this is triangle ADE. Okay. This is the triangle ADE. If I just slightly move this triangle like this, can you tell me now this AD is going to be the base and EN it's going to be the height, right? Because this was the triangle. We have just turned it this way. So what base are we going to get? We are going to get AD, that is base, and height is EN. So we will write this now. So we are taking only the proof part now. We have the area of triangle ADE, that is ADE, divided by area of triangle BDE, that is BDE. So let me show it to you, this triangle BDE. I will keep this triangle here, BDE, which is an obtuse triangle. Okay, so area of triangle ADE is equal to half base into height. So half we will write as it is. What is the base in triangle ADE? We have the base here because height this is showing. So we have the base AD into height as EN. Okay. In the next triangle, area of triangle BDE, this is BDE. If I just join this both, can you see here? This is the obtuse angled triangle BDE. So in the case, we have already seen where the height of the obtuse angled triangle is going to be. So the height of the obtuse angled triangle is going to be outside the triangle. In the same way, the height of this obtuse angle triangle BDE is going to be outside, that is again going to be EN. EN is going to be the height of the triangle BDE. So area of triangle BDE is equal to half into base, which is the base, DB is the base, and height is EN. I hope you are understanding this. So this is going to be the equation 1. So now what is happening? 1 by 2 and 1 by 2, they get cancelled. Then similar things get cancelled. EN by EN get cancelled. 1 by 2, 1 by 2 get cancelled. What is remaining? AD by DB is remaining. That is our equation 1 now. Similarly, I told you initially we will take ADE and BDE. We have finished with that, ADE and BDE. Next we will be taking ADE and CDE. So you can see that area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle CDE is equal to half base into height, half base into height. So up into base. Now we want the triangle ADE again. So we want the area of triangle ADE, so which is ADE. Now we have the base as AE and height as DM. So half into base, base is AE and height is DM. Half into AE into DM. Okay, half AE into DM. Next, we want the area of triangle CDE. We have C, D and E. CDE is an obtuse angle triangle. So, its height is going to be away from the, outside the triangle, that is DM. If I join it, you can see that this is an obtuse angle triangle and we have the height outside. So, DM is going to be the height for CDE triangle also. So, half into base. Base is EC. In the triangle CDE, base is EC and height is DM. Going to get now, half and half will get cancelled and DM and DM will get cancelled. We are left with AE by EC. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So, what is left now from equation 1 and 2? We have AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So, we wanted to prove this itself, right? So, we have proved it now. See, just look at the prove step. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. See, we have proved the same thing now. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So, this is the proof of the Thales theorem. See, logically, if you want to just learn it logically, I will show you another step. Just look at to prove. We have here, I told you that we are going to follow logically. So, ADE and BDE first we will take. So, area of triangle ADE by area of triangle BDE. You have to write half up and half down. What is there in the left part of to prove AD by DB? So, this itself you take away and put here AD by DB. The same thing you are going to write. So, what have we constructed? Perpendicular first EN. So, this EN itself you pick up and write here EN by EN. This is logically okay. So, EN, EN gets cancelled, half of gets cancelled, AD by DB, the only thing that is remaining. Now, we will take, as I told you, first we will take A and B, next we will take A and C. So, triangle ADE and CDE. So, triangle ADE, area of triangle AD by area of triangle CD is equal to, again you will write up half, down half. What is the next one we need to prove? We need to prove AE by EC. So, pick it up and write AE by EC. What is the next perpendicular that we have drawn? We have drawn DM, right? So, pick it up and write DM by DM. So, DM, DM cancels, half of cancels, AE by EC is remaining. That is our equation 2. So, you can directly write from 1 and 2, we have AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. So, that was the logical part. I don't know how you have understood. I hope you do good. So, keep watching and please like, share and subscribe. We will come back in our next video with the Pythagoras theorem. Until then, goodbye. Be happy.